Step 1, evaluation. Evaluate the situation to determine why the floor isn't level. There can be a variety of reasons that a floor can fall out of level with the rest of the house, such as home additions that were not properly leveled, or issues that occur due to moisture or the foundation settling. Each reason will require a specific set of steps to fix the problem. Not all of the following steps will be necessary to fix every situation, but the first step to starting any floor leveling job is to use a level, a straight edge, or a string to determine if and how much the floor is out of level or out of plane with the rest of the house. Step 2, diagnosis. After you have evaluated that the floor is indeed out of level or out of plane with the rest of the house, it is time to diagnose the reason or reasons why. Only leveling the floor without correcting the underlying causes will result in a fix that will have to be repaired again over time. Getting to the root of the problem is extremely important. Otherwise, it's a good idea to start with an inspection of the foundation or crawl space. Look for rotten wood or signs of mold, evidence of insect damage, foundation settling, or areas with excessive moisture. This may require the use of a moisture meter. Test the subfloor for areas of weakness. After inspecting the crawl space, return inside to inspect the layers of the floor. This can be done by removing an air register or by removing a baseboard and drilling a small hole through the floor to expose the layers. Look for evidence of improper flooring additions or water damage. If there is any indication of water damage, be sure to test surrounding drywall for moisture damage as well. Step 3, replace framing members. Now that the floor has been thoroughly inspected and the problems have been diagnosed, it's time to begin the repair. For a house with moisture damage or damage from insect infestation to the framing members, begin by tearing out any affected insulation and then replacing all of the rotten girders, fan joists, and floor joists. Step 4, raise the floor and fix sags. Once all of the affected flooring frame has been replaced, it's time to replace or install sill plates and to fix any areas where floor joists are sagging. These portions of the job will be done in tandem. The drop girders will provide the necessary support to the floor joists to fix the sagging flooring frame, and the new sill plates will support the floor and walls once they have been brought into proper alignment. For areas that have a sag across long runs of floor joists, drop girders can be used to add support and to reinforce sagging floor joists. Depending on the size of the crawl space and the length of the drop girder being installed, it may be necessary to begin by knocking out a few strategically placed holes in the foundation so that drop girders can be positioned across the repaired floor frame to create a support crib for raising the floor and walls. Once the drop girders are in place, position 4x4 timbers on top of securely positioned bottle jacks and begin slowly raising the floor. As soon as enough room has been created, position treated lumber into the space between the foundation walls and the floor. Continue slowly raising the floor and walls and filling the gap with treated lumber until proper alignment has been reached. If there is space, add a sill seal gasket between the sill plate and the foundation wall. Otherwise, use an alternative air sealing technique where the sill plate meets the foundation. Once the floor frame has been raised to the proper height, the new sill plates have been installed, and the new drop girder has been securely positioned under the floor joists and across both foundation walls, the bottle jacks can be safely removed. Step 5, add subfloor sleepers. Once the floor frame and walls have been brought into alignment and any sagging areas have been fixed, return inside to bring the newly leveled subfloor to the desired height. If the floor needs to be raised multiple inches, add subfloor sleepers perpendicular to the floor joists to raise the height of the floor across the room. Secure each sleeper to the floor with the proper fasteners. Step 6, install new subfloor. Apply a bead of flooring adhesive along the face of each of the sleepers. Then lay the new tongue and groove subfloor into position on top of the sleepers. Once all of the new subfloor is locked into place, use screws to secure the subfloor to the sleepers. Using screws that are long enough to reach through the sleepers to the original subfloor, along with adhesive, will ensure that the new subfloor is held tightly in place and that it won't squeak over time. Step 7, install flooring. Now that the sleepers and the new subfloor are installed and the floor has been raised to the correct height, it is time to install the flooring of choice to finish the room. Step 8, seal the crawl space. Once the flooring frame and the walls have been made level, the floor has been returned to the proper height, and the final finished flooring has been installed, it's time to replace and repair any blocks or bricks that were removed from the foundation and to make sure that the crawl space is tightly sealed and insulated to prevent moisture problems or insect infestations from returning. This demonstration is intended for professionals only. Homeowners should not attempt these projects without first consulting a licensed professional.